It was down by Egan's Corner, one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel there, and this to him did say, "We have orders from the captain to assemble at Drumbar. Oh, but how were we to get there without a motor car?" "Well, Barney dear, be of good cheer, and I'll tell you what we'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, and the IRA are few. We'll wire on Tustin Orler, and before we'll get that far, we'll give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnston's motor car." When Dr. Johnston got the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, "This is an urgent case, and there is no time to lose." He then put on his castor hat, and upon his breast a star. You could hear the din going through Glenfinn up Johnston's motor car. Well, when he got to the Reeland Bridge, the rebels he saw there. He knew the game was up with him, for at him they did stare. He said, "I have a permit to travel near and far. You can stick your English permit, we want your motor car." "What will my loyal brethren say whenere they hear the news? My car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Marr. And when Ireland gets her freedom, you'll get your motor car." They set the car in motion and filled it to the brim with rifles and with bayonets. This made old Johnston grim. And Barney hoisted the Sinn Féin flag, and it fluttered like a star. And they gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnston's motor car.